Haley, welcome back to my channel. As you can tell, I'm super excited about this video right now because, as you can tell by the little title down there, I am filming my March 2018 favorites. Woohoo! I'm so excited to tell you guys all my favorites from the month of March. It's from high-end to drugstore, through some throwbacks is what I'm trying to say, of some products that I rediscovered in my makeup collection. So if you guys would like to see all my favorites from the month of March, then please keep watching. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. I'm not gonna go in any particular order. I might go in the order of how I put them on my face, but I'm just gonna kind of show you guys all my favorite stuff for the month of March. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm also gonna try to not to talk too fast or get my tongue all twisted when I'm saying these products, but I don't want this video to be overly long either. So if you guys have any questions about the products that I'm mentioning, I will have them listed down in the description box down below as well, or you can leave a comment and I'll make sure to respond back to you as soon as I can. So let's go ahead and get started. So one of the first products that has actually transformed my skin for the better has been this Boscia, I don't know, I'm totally gonna butcher this name, called Tuboski Glotion. I don't know exactly how you pronounce it. If you can't see some of these items, I will, like I said, list them down in the bottom. But what this is a very hydrating, you can use it as a primer or a moisturizer. It kind of has like a pink, almost like a, it's not glitter, it's just kind of like a, adds a nice glow to the skin, which is so amazing. I love putting this on after my moisturizer and kind of using it as a primer. So this has been my go-to. You can pick this up at Sephora.com or in the stores. So amazing. So the other product that I'm going to be talking about with you is this. I have two foundations that I'm going to share with you guys today that have been a staple in my March favorites for sure. The first one is the Almay. This is their Clear Complexion 4-in-1. It's a blemish eraser. So I don't know if you guys have noticed, but on some of my posts, my acne has just been so flared up lately, and I wasn't too sure as to what was going on, but I think I might have figured it out, that it was a certain foundation that I was using, so I completely stopped using it. If you have any questions about what it was, let me know. But anyways, that's not the point of this video. So I did discover this Almay Clear Complexion. I discovered it from actually a YouTuber on here. I can't remember her name right now. But anyways, she had mentioned this and that it helped clear up her skin. And ever since I've been using this, my skin hasn't looked flawless per se, but it has looked very nice, very hydrated. This foundation's not overly matte or anything like that. So if you haven't tried the Almay Clear Complexion, go get yourself some because it's so amazing. The next foundation that I have fallen in love with from the month of March, geez, I'm really gonna get tongue twisted in this video, is the Maybelline. This is their new revamped Super Stay Foundation. When I saw this come out with this product, I was laughing so hard because back in the day when I first started wearing makeup and everything, like in 10th and 11th grade, my mom used to use the Maybelline Super Stay, the original one, and that's how I kind of got into wearing foundation. That was one of the first foundations I ever tried, so when I saw them come up and revamp this, I was so excited to retry it because I totally forgot what it was like because they completely took it off the market a couple years ago. So I love this foundation. I did get it in one of the lightest shades that they have, so I do have to mix it in with dark drops that I use from NYX to kind of get my shade. But yeah, I've been loving this foundation. It's really full coverage from what I've seen from the drugstore, so if that's what you're looking for, go and try it out. I haven't regretted it since then and it hasn't broken me out, so that's amazing. The next product that I've been loving recently from the month of March, my friend Marissa, shout out to you, recommended me to go pick this up at TJ Maxx. It is a rose hibiscus water, and I had to make sure that this particular spray didn't have fragrance in it because I think that's also what's been breaking out my skin. I'm just super sensitive. So this has hyaluronic acid. It's a refreshing body and face mist, so I like to kind of spray this all over my face after I've cleansed my skin or after I finish doing my makeup, or it says you can also do it throughout the day, and this does not have fragrance in it. So I got this at TJ Maxx. It was only $6.99 in their little skincare section. So if you guys need a little hydrating boost or mist throughout the day, go and get yourself some. It's amazing. The other product that I'm going to be talking about, which I have discovered of the month of March, this is from Flower Beauty. I still have yet to try their foundation and concealer, so if you guys have tried them, please leave a comment down below and tell me if you like their foundation or concealer, because I still want to try it out. I kind of want to make a video about it and kind of see my first impression. But anyways, this is the Flower Seal the Deal Hydrating Setting Mist. This is going to give more of like a dewy finish. I've been loving this for kind of setting my face or just throughout the day, so I kind of like blending these two sprays together throughout the day just to kind of keep my skin plump and hydrated. The other product that has definitely caught my eye was the Maybelline Superstay Better Skin. This is kind of their powder foundation. It's super nice. I kind of wish that the whole pan was filled with the powder instead of like this dinky sponge. Sometimes I use this on the go, so that's why it's dirty, but I normally don't recommend to use the sponges that come with it. But I love this. It's a perfect shade for me. I got it in the shade 10 Porcelain. It's nice just to put on after your foundation if you tend to get a little bit oily, or if you just kind of want to set the areas that you feel that might get oily throughout the day and everything like that. But I love this Superstay Better Than Skin powder foundation. I'm losing my train of thought. I think I just need to take a deep breath. But the next product that I've been loving these two concealers. I rediscovered this one from Revlon, and I recently picked up in the month of March this Maybelline Instant Age Rewind. I, in the past, did not like this concealer at all, the Maybelline one. It just wasn't working for me, like, couple of months ago, but I decided to give it a try it again, and I've been really loving it. I got mine in the shade Light. And yeah, it really helps combat dark circles, helps brighten up everything. I don't really use this on spots on my face. I have yet to try that out, but I have used it underneath my eyes, and it works really well. So the other concealer that I have fallen in love with that I also used to use way back in the day is the Revlon ColorStay Concealer. And I got mine in the shade Light because my skin is deciding to be super white lately because there hasn't been much sun here in California, so I haven't gotten the chance to go outside and get a nice tan. But anyways, I really love this for kind of spot concealing if I just want to wear like concealer and some powder foundation instead of doing the whole foundation routine. I've been really loving this, or even after my foundation. So if you haven't tried this concealer out, please do so, because it's amazing and it's at the drugstore. The other product that I've been falling in love with recently for the month of March is this Wet n Wild brow pencil. And I know you guys are thinking, like, what? Wet n Wild, like, you really like that brow pencil, because it's only like $4 or $5, if I'm not mistaken. But it has a little pencil on the side, and then it also has the little spoolie as well, which is amazing for kind of brushing up the brow hairs and just kind of distributing the product throughout. And ever since I dyed my hair dark, it's been super hard for me to find a perfect brow pencil color that is best for my hair and just my brows and kind of matching and everything. So I've been really loving this Wet n Wild one. It's so affordable. If you haven't tried it out, please do so. There is some other high-end ones that I like using sometimes, but if I'm just using it every day, I don't want to go and spend $20 on an eyebrow pencil. So the fact that this is only like $3, maybe $5 is amazing. The other product, and I know you guys are going to guess this for my favorite mascaras because I've been sharing it all over Instagram and all over all my social medias, this is the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise Mascara, and I did get mine in just the regular, not the waterproof, because the first time I got it, I did get the waterproof, and it would not come off my eyeballs. So if you guys are going swimming or in the ocean or in the water, I feel like a little fuzzy on my nose. Don't you hate that when you have like a little fuzzy on your nose? Anyways, but I did pick up the waterproof one in the first place, and it didn't come off. That's what I was trying to say. Again, I lost my train of thought. But I love this mascara to the point of what I was trying to say is this mascara is amazing. Again, it's at the drugstore. I feel like all my favorite products are at the drugstore, if you guys haven't noticed. I do like to kind of dip my toes into high-end stuff every once in a while, but because I don't want to spend a bunch of money on makeup all the time, I kind of want to just have it there like at Target or CVS or whenever I'm running errands. If I'm running out of something, I want to be able to go and pick it up and not have to go travel to different places to try to track down a certain product. So if you haven't tried the Voluminous Lash Paradise, you really should, because it's a bomb mascara. The next product that I'm going to be sharing with you are two highlighters that I have been loving lately, and surprisingly, they are both from Maybelline. I love them so much. So one of them is actually a single eyeshadow. I think I might have mentioned this in a probably all my videos, let's be honest, but in most of my videos, this is a single eyeshadow that I love using on my cheekbones. Today I actually have the other one on my cheekbones, but I've been loving this one as well. It's like, I don't know, a couple dollars, like maybe $2 to $4 from Maybelline. It's called the Glow Down. It's just a really pretty single eyeshadow, but I like to use it as highlighter on the cheekbones, and it's so pretty. If you're much fairer than me, it might not work out for you, but I don't know if you guys can really see that on the back of my hand, but for it being like $3 to $4, it is amazing. So if you don't have this, it's a single eyeshadow. You can use it as eyeshadow, because I use it as that as well, and on my cheekbones. So go get yourself some. And the next highlighter that has been raved about on YouTube is this Maybelline Master Chrome. So you know that I had to go and pick this out and try it for myself. And it is amazing. This is the one in Molten Gold. They also have a Rose Gold one that I have yet to try out. I really want to try that one. It's more of like a pink champagne, but this is gold. So I love, love, love this one. Super pretty. Let me just show you it next to the single eyeshadow, just so you can kind of compare the two. Hopefully it isn't washing it out. But this one right here is the eyeshadow, and then this one right here is the Molten Gold. So that one, they're pretty comparable. I will say that the Master Chrome is just a little bit more pigmented than the eyeshadow. You'd have to kind of build this one up a little bit more to kind of get the same effect. But they're both so amazing. So if you need some good gold, champagne-y type of drugstore highlighters, definitely try both of these out, because they're amazing and they won't let you down. Next, I'm going to jump into, it's fallen right here. I have been on like a blush hunt, because I really don't wear blush that often, or at least I didn't in the past. So now I've been trying to, again, dip my toes into some new products from the drugstore especially. And I went to Ulta not too long ago in March, and I found this Makeup Revolution. This is their matte blush. It's so pretty. It doesn't have a scent to it, but I got mine in the shade Nude, and it's just that perfect blush for like an everyday. It's not too peach, it's not too red, it's not too orange, it's not everything. It's just the perfect natural, again, nude type of blush. So if you guys are looking for a new blush to add to your collection, got to get this blush. I believe you can find it at Ulta. I'm not too sure where else they sell Makeup Revolution, but I found mine at Ulta, so I'm sure you can't go wrong on finding it there. You guys also are going to know what my favorite bronzer is, because I've been using this in the past couple videos and raving about it as well. This is the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. I love this bronzer. I have to give a shout out to Tanya Chabon. I think that's how you say her name. She's also a YouTuber here. I'll try to link her stuff down below as well, but she inspires me so much to try new stuff. So she was recently obsessed with this butter bronzer, and of course I had to go and pick it up and retry it again for myself. And it's just so creamy. It smells like you're in paradise, like coconut, and it just so good for a drugstore bronzer. It is a little bit up there on the pricier side, so it's kind of, I think it's like maybe $13 to $15, but this has lasted me so long, and I haven't even hit pan on it yet. I use it every day, sometimes twice a day, and it's just an amazing bronzer. So I'm going to try to move a little bit more quickly through the rest of this stuff so this video is not overly long. Try to keep it under 15 minutes, but I'm going to go ahead and step in with my favorite two eyeshadow palettes for the month of March. I did, I think, already mention this one in my other favorites video, but I'm going to mention it again because it's just such an amazing palette, and I love Jaclyn Hill so much, and Morphe. I just can't believe their collaboration. It's just such an amazing palette. So now that I have it in my hand, I might as well open it up so you guys can see what it looks like. I'm sure you all have seen this all over Instagram and all over YouTube. I have yet to create a YouTube video while using this palette. I don't think I have yet. If you guys want to see any certain looks within this palette, let me know. I kind of want to dig into these colorful ones and maybe smoke it out. We can even do a natural look. That's why I love this palette so much, because you can kind of do anything with it, and that's what I love. So shout out to you, Jaclyn and Morphe. Again, I've been obsessed with this palette. They're so pigmented. It's only like 40 bucks, and it's not limited edition anymore as far as I'm aware, so you can definitely go and pick it up on the Morphe website. And actually, side note, Ulta just started carrying Morphe products, so if you have an Ulta near you, give them a call, because they might have the palette actually in stock, so you don't have to online order, because I'm not a very patient person when it comes to wanting new makeup stuff. So if you call them, I'm sure they'll have it in your local Ulta. So the other eyeshadow palette that I've been loving recently, and I've had this for a couple months now, but I kind of rediscovered it again in my collection. I just feel like I have so much makeup all the time that I kind of forget about products, and I'm sure you guys are kind of like that as well. But this is the Tartlet in Bloom palette. I love this palette. Something about the Tarte palettes I'm just so obsessed with. Their smell, just everything. And they're pretty affordable. I mean, you're getting a lot of eyeshadows for, I think it's maybe between 30 and 40 bucks, but it's really good pricing. I've been loving these two shades in particular called Sweetheart and Rebel, just for like an everyday type of eyeshadow. So I've been really, really, really loving this palette. If you don't have it in your collection or any other Tarte palettes, you need to go get yourself some because I freaking love this palette. So I think I only have lips to talk about last, so let's get this rolling so this video is not too long. But I've been loving this lip liner recently from Sephora Collection. It is called Number 2 Nothing But Nude, and this lip liner is so nice. I'm going to give you a little swatch on the back of my hand so you can kind of see what it looks like. It is just that perfect nude shade. It's not too pink, not too orange, doesn't have any like weird type of... What the heck am I gonna just say? Like any type of weird like spacing in between. You know how sometimes, because this is a gel lip liner, so sometimes gel lip liners or just lip liners in general, they kind of like break up, if that makes sense, like when you're lining your lips. But this particular formula just kind of goes on super smoothly. That's what I'm trying to say. It's a very smooth lip liner. So if you guys are looking in the market for a new lip liner, these are, I think, are about maybe $12 at Sephora. They're amazing, so go check them out. They have a wide variety of colors. And then my two, last but not least, favorite lipsticks are both from MAC. I really do like drugstore lipsticks, but I've been addicted to these two. They're always in my backpack, always in my purse, always with me. And the first shade is called Modesty, and then I also have Honey Love. And both of these shades are so beautiful. I'm going to go ahead and swatch it on this hand for you so you can kind of see what each one looks like, because of course, everybody's gonna say like they look the same, but they actually look so different on the lips. So they might look closely the same on my lips, but you can never have enough nude pink lipsticks. So this one right here is called Honey Love. So see how it has kind of like that warmer undertone? It's like kind of more nude warm. And then this one right here is called Modesty. I really like this one because it has that more pinky nude. So I personally feel like I have to have both of these in my collection to be completely satisfied. And of course, I have so many other nudes. All right, you guys, so that concludes my video for today of my March favorites. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, please give this video a big thumbs up since it does help out my channel so much. And if you haven't already, what are you doing? Please hit the little red subscribe button. I'm not too sure which side it's on. And also hit the little notification bell. That'll notify you every time I do upload a YouTube video. Again, I'm trying to get back in action of uploading at least twice a week. So if you guys have any recommendations or makeup looks or types of videos that you'd like to see from my channel, please leave them down in the comments below. And other than that, I will leave the products that I mentioned today listed in the description box just in case I spoke too quickly about the products, which I tend to do. So if you feel like I need to slow down, let me know. But I'm just a very fast talker. But other than that, I'm so happy to be back and filming again. So if you guys, I don't know what else I'm trying to say, stumbling over my words again, but I can't wait to see you guys in my next video. Bye!